This is yellow root. It grows throughout my mountain holler, throughout Appalachian in the southeast, most of the time along a creek like right here behind us. Not many people in Appalachia use yellow root today for medicinal remedies, but there are still a few people who do. You can see where it gets its name from its bright yellow inside of the root. Appalachia is full of medicinal remedies, from using wild plants to superstitious folklore like cutting a piece of your hair and putting it in a tree that's been struck by lightning to prevent headaches. You'll hear all kinds of things when it comes to being healthy in Appalachia. Of course, when you're doing this type of video today, you have to start out by saying, I'm not advising anyone to use these remedies. You'd have to talk with your doctor and decide what's best for you when it comes to your own medical health, instead of listening to old wives' tales and folklore and medicinal remedies passed down through Appalachia. My friend Carolyn Anderson is one of those people who still gathers yellow root and uses it. She gathers the roots and dries them. You can use yellow root for a stomach ailment. That's what Carolyn does. You can make a tea out of the fresh yellow root or dried yellow root, and you just keep it in your fridge and you use it as needed. Yellow root can be used dried up, dried and ground yellow root can be used to make a salve. So you mix it with something else, with an oil or something like that, and then you use that on cuts and burns, abrasions, those type things for a healing agent. Yellow root can also be used in dried form. In days gone by, it was used often. They would grind it up and then they would sprinkle it across an open cut or a wound or an abrasion to help stop infection and to help heal faster. The most common usage for yellow root that I've heard while I was growing up in Appalachia was anything related to your mouth. So think mouth ulcers, a sore throat, something going on with your gums. Those are the things that it's most commonly used for. And that's the only experience I have with using yellow root. When Matt and I were going to be married 26 years ago, we just had an anniversary, I had terrible mouth ulcers. Looking back, I probably had them because I was nervous about getting married, nervous about the wedding, even though our wedding wasn't very large or elaborate or anything. But I was probably nervous about all those things, and that probably made those ulcers worse in my mouth. But I was miserable, and as the day of our marriage grew closer and closer, I was afraid that I might not even be able to say I do when we actually got up to the altar, you know. So Pap went to the creek and he got some yellow root. He brought it back and he made me a tea to swish around in my mouth, and I did that for several days. He also told me just to chew on the roots. I remember I was mowing Pap and Granny's yard and I was chewing on that root thinking I would die. But I was so desperate to do anything so that those places in my mouth would get better before my big wedding day. And it did actually help. But I will tell you, it's the most vile, terrible, bitter tasting stuff that you've ever tasted. It's horrible. But I actually do think it healed those ulcers in my mouth. At least it speeded up their healing so that on my day I was able to say I do without worrying about it. Those pretty yellow roots that I showed you can be used to dye things too, like yarn and thread and cloth. A lot of people that do natural dyeing, they use yellow root as a dye. And my favorite story about yellow root is about dyeing, and it comes from Granny. So when Granny was a little girl, of course in those days they needed wood for pretty much everything, so getting wood was a constant daily activity for somebody. And in Granny's family, her two older brothers, George and Junior, was responsible for getting the wood. Well, they had a wheelbarrow that they would put it in from the wood pile, and then they made a ramp that went up on the porch, and if they got a real good run and go, they could get all the way up on the porch to the front door, and it made it easier to get the wood in, you know, instead of having to carry it up the steps. Well, one day Junior wasn't there, and George was doing it by himself, and Granny was out playing in the yard with her sisters, and just as he got close to it, he said, "Hey, somebody come help me push." Well, Granny, even though she's the littlest, thought she'd help push. Well, somehow, about the time she got there, I guess he realized she might get hurt, and he told her to back up or whatever, and she fell, and she busted her head. So she said, she remembered it hurt, and she remembered blood being everywhere and everyone running to see if she was okay. But she said, "What I remembered most of all was my mother dyed a yellow scarf, made a pretty yellow scarf to tie my head up with." As soon as Granny had got hurt and busted her head, Granny Gazzy went to the creek and got yellow root, and she dyed a pretty piece of cloth. Of course, it wasn't ready till the next day, but that, you know, if you bust your head open, it's going to be sore for a couple of days. And then she tied Granny's head up with it. And I just think that's the sweetest story. I'm sure that Granny Gazzy could have tied her head up with anything, but she took the time and the trouble to go get something really pretty. She made a pretty yellow cloth for Granny's head. It's sad that we've lost so much medicinal knowledge. It's passed down through the generations. It's just not like that today. There are still some people with that knowledge, and I'm so glad that there are. And there's books and different things that you can learn from. I'm also thankful for modern medicine, though. I always think of my girls. They'll be 24 in a week. I would have never carried them to full term. I didn't actually carry them to full term. I would have never carried them to be alive, is what I'm trying to say, I guess, if I hadn't had a great doctor with modern technology that knew how to take care of them and me and make sure we were all right. So I'm very thankful for that. I just wish that we had somehow retained some of the knowledge that we had of plants and different things. And like I said, there are still some people that have that, and I'm so thankful for them. But I get to thinking about those old superstitions, especially sometimes, like the one with the hair. If you cut your hair and put it in a tree that's been struck by lightning. Another one you've probably heard is if you put an axe or a knife under someone's bed who's in pain, like, for example, a woman in labor, that it will cut their pain. You know, well, when you first hear that, you think, well, that's just silly. You know, who would believe that? But if you believe in mind over matter, maybe it's not so silly. You know, you think about in days gone by, if you were a mother watching your daughter give birth for the first time and she was in labor that was just unbearable and you had nothing to help her and nothing to do, you know, it would help you to believe that an axe or a knife would cut her pain, but it would also help her. I know that if I was the woman in labor in the bed and my mother or my grandmother told me that, you know, I'm going to put this axe or this knife under the bed and cut your pain, that would give me something to focus on, something to help me through that pain, thinking that I believed them, I trusted them, they were my family, they loved me, and that somehow that might help me get past those labor pains to the birth of my child. So maybe they're not as silly as we think they are. At least that's how I think about it. I appreciate you sitting a spell with me today. I hope if you've got any medicinal remedies that's been passed down through your family or that you're familiar with, I hope that you'll leave them in the comments. I hope that you'll share this video with your friends and neighbors, but mostly I just hope you'll drop back by often as I celebrate Appalachia. Oh, and subscribing to my channel will really help me celebrate Appalachia, so please, please join in and help me do that. Have a great day.